When it comes to expectations, I think it's very important to be as explicit as possible, both from the standpoint of the mentor as well as the mentee.
There are all kinds of things you have to consider and talk with prospective mentors about, or current mentors, because things can come up even when you're already in a lab.
Just because your expectations don't align doesn't mean you can't get on the same page. The point is to get your expectations out in the open so you can have an open communication about them.
Having a discussion with both your research advisor and your lab mates about the day-to-day expectations for behavior and work in the team is important. So things like, you know, how do we keep our lab notebooks? What do we do if we use up one of the reagents or we use up a solution? What about in terms of sharing equipment or in terms of collaborating on different aspects of projects? And who has priority to use different pieces of equipment? If you're the last person to leave, what is the expectation? If you're the first person who arrives, what is the expectation? And generally, just timelines for how quickly things will get done. With regard to the research project that you're going to do, it's really important to align your expectations with your research advisor. Exactly what are the goals and the specific aims of that project, right? Is it already laid out or is it yet to be determined? And what are we going to do if the results don't turn out in the way that we thought that they were going to turn out? One of the things that when I was a postdoctoral fellow that my mentor did was that she expected the people in her lab to like make a figure of every experiment. And then when I would meet with her, it was so much easier than to go through my messy lab notebook, which I had to keep as well. So I would have my lab notebook there, but then we would have this figure and we could talk around the figure. That was really great that she was explicit in laying out that expectation for me.
One of the tough things that grad students and their research advisors can face is really getting on the same page about how much time grad students should spend doing their research.
It really, really does differ from lab to lab. When I was a graduate student, I had been in graduate school for a while and decided I deserved a vacation and disappeared for 2 weeks. And it never occurred to me to tell my professor that I was going to be away for 2 weeks. And when I got back, he pulled me into his office and said, "You know, you need to tell me what you're up to." And I thought, "Oh, okay, I didn't know that."
So it might be the case that your career goals are different from what your major advisor would want you to do. Being open and transparent about what your other goals are and what other kinds of learning experiences that you need to have in order to achieve those goals is important. When you're talking to your advisor about these things, tell them about the skills that you're going to be learning to do this and how those skills can be applied to the research that they would like you to focus on. I see this a lot actually in teaching. Like students who teach a lot, they just are, now you're up in front of an audience, if you will, 3 days a week, every time you teach, you get better at presenting. And your understanding of, depending on what you're teaching, of those concepts gets deeper. These other kinds of experiences can enhance your ability to do good research. And it's important that you point this out to your mentor.
So in the instance where there's a misalignment of mentorship expectations, it's worth having a conversation.
You may feel like you just have to sit back and listen and do whatever they say. But you should speak up and say something if you don't feel like that expectation is going to be something that you're going to be able to meet, or you'd like it to be modified. If they have expectations about when you're going to get certain experiments done, for example, but you know you still have classes maybe and you have an exam coming up and you're going to need a little extra time. In my experience, advisors and mentors will be very understanding if you just explain where you're coming from.
You're not the same person at the beginning of an experience to when you're at the end of like a formal research experience. And so you should always have check-ins, you know, every 3 to 6 months. So the expectations are always up to date.
It's really important to be on the same page, to have ample opportunity to communicate, to make sure that you all are aligning your expectations around what success looks like on a regular basis. And what that means in concrete ways.